Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, you will see how to filter and sort data in the Vue Pivot Table component. So first, I will open an existing Vue application that has a Pivot Table component with a list of data retrieved from a local data source. If you want to know how to get started with the Vue Pivot Table component, refer to the video linked in the card above. I will run the application using the npm run dev command and show the initial demo. You can see the pivot table is rendered with the defined data. Now let's see how to filter the data in the pivot table. To enable the filtering option on the pivot table, I need to enable the grouping bar or field list functionality. In this example, I have already enabled the grouping bar functionality. So let me start to filter the data. Here, the filtering icon appears on fields that are bound to rows and columns, because you can filter only the rows and columns axis data. To demonstrate the filtering, I click on the filter icon of the date field. You can see a dialog box appears on the screen with a list of years and a search bar. Now I want to show only the records from the years 2007 and 2008. So I will uncheck the years 2005 and 2006 from the list and click OK. The pivot table displays the records for the given 2 years. By default, the filter dialog loads all the items in the table, but you can limit the number of items by setting the max node limit in member editor property. To demonstrate, inside the data function, I define a variable max node limit in member editor and set its value to 2. Then, I assign this variable to the component using the max node limit in member editor property. Now you can see the filter dialog opens with the first 2 members in the data source, 2005 and 2006. You also see a notification here with the remaining number of members. You can search them in the search text box for further filtering. Okay, I have shown you the steps to perform the default member filtering in the UI using the grouping bar option. Now let's proceed to do this filtering programmatically. To do this, I define the filter settings property, which accepts any number of filter settings within it. But for now, I am going to set a single filter setting for the product field. So, I set the name property to product, the type to exclude, and I set items to bike, because I want to exclude the records of bike from the pivot table. You can see the pivot table is rendered only with records for cars. Apart from this default member filtering type, the Syncfusion Vue Pivot Table also supports 2 other filtering types, label filtering and value filtering. First, let's look into the label filtering type. To enable the label filtering, I define the AllowLabelFilter property and set its value to true. When I click on the filter icon of the country field, the dialog opens and within the label filtering tab, there is a dropdown with a list of operators. Here I choose the contains operator and enter the value SW in the text box. When I click OK, the pivot table refreshes and displays only Sweden, which contains SW. In the same way, you can perform label filtering for number or date types by selecting the appropriate operators. Now I will show you how to perform the same in the code. To demonstrate, I will use the number type field, quantity. Within filter settings, I will change the existing filter setting by changing the name property to quantity, the type to number, and set the condition to between. To filter the quantity values between 30 and 40. Then I will remove the quantity field from the value axis and add it to the row axis, because it is possible to filter only the row and column axis values. You can now see the pivot table rendered with quantities ranging between 30 and 40. Next, I will move on to the next type, value filtering. This type is used to filter the aggregated values in the values axis. To enable this filtering, I define the allowValueFilter property and set its value to true. When you click the filter icon of the date field, the filter dialog opens. Within the value filtering tab, I am going to filter the years with sales amounts of $4,020. Here the pivot table shows the records with the specified sales amount. This filtering action can also be performed programmatically. All right, let's move on to sorting. In order to enable the default sorting in the pivot table, you need to enable the grouping bar or field list functionality. Since the grouping bar has been already enabled, let me start sorting the data. You can see the sort icons on fields bound to rows and columns. Now I am going to sort the country field in descending order. Okay, this is the default string-based member sorting. Suppose you have fields with a combination of letters and numbers, and you want to sort them based on the numbers. You can use the alphanumeric sorting type. Let's see how to perform alphanumeric sorting. Let me modify the existing data source by including an alphanumeric field, units, to it. I will bind this units field to the row axis. For a clear explanation, I will remove the other fields on rows. Now I am going to sort this alphanumeric field based on numbers. So, I will set the data type to number in the rows property. Now the row axis has the alphanumeric field, units, in it. Here, the members of the units field are sorted in ascending order. I will sort it in descending order by clicking the sort icon. Next, I will show you how to perform value sorting. This method of sorting is used to sort the individual value and aggregated values in rows or columns. To demonstrate, I will define a variable, enableValueSorting, and set its value to true. Now, I need to assign this variable to the enableValueSorting property of the pivot table component. Now I plan to sort the values of the amount field in the fiscal year 2006 in descending order. To do this, I will define the value sort settings property and set the header text to FI2006 double hash amount. Header delimiter as double hash. And finally, sort order to descending. Here this header delimiter is a separator value that separates the header text between levels. To better illustrate the sorting process in the amount field, let me include the quantity field as well in the values axis. Now the amount field in the year 2006 is sorted in descending order. In this video, I have shown you how to filter and sort data in the pivot table component. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Vue products through our community license. If you found this video useful, do like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.